bug.
Big bug.
Hi guys, Ayan, what are we making today?
Water alarm!
Good job!
Water alarm will help you get up in the morning. For sure, you will not be able to miss it. Let's do this.
To make a water alarm, we need a alarm clock, a toy car, a scale, scissors, screwdriver, some glue, a cup, dub kit, thread.
Before we get started, you need to make sure you are always doing this in the presence of your parents. You cannot do this when you are alone, okay? So, what we do is we get a toy car. This car needs to have a motor inside. You know, that is crucial for this alarm. If you don't have a motor, this experiment will not work. So, what you do is you take a small screwdriver, and you open up your car. Say goodbye to your car.
Goodbye.
Okay, once we have opened all four screws, they should pop out. And pull it up. Pull it out.
Ah!
Whoa. Once you have opened the your toy, you will find two things which you would need. One is this motor. The second is a switch right here. You see, this switch usually is for turning the toy on and off. You'll require the switch and you'll require the motor. I got the motor and the switch from the car. Now what we need is this holder to hold the batteries to power this motor. But Ayan is very attached to the car, so I decided to use one that I had from my previous experiment. I had this with me. This is from another toy, so I'll use this. Okay, it's the same thing as this, just in a different shape. The connections are very simple. You have your two wires connecting to the motor here. It goes all the way to the switch. There's a wire connecting from the switch. It is connected to one end of the power. This is the power where you will charge your, put your batteries in. And the other is connected to the other end of the motor. All right, the connection is made. The next step is to get your alarm clock. Now there is a glass here. What we need to do is we need to remove the glass. Okay, now the glass is off. What you need to do now is remove the second hand. Ayan, you want to do it?
Yes.
So you want to use your hand?
Yes, this is the second hand. We have to remove it.
Okay. What we need to do now is take this. This is the holder, the battery holder. And you have to place this on top of the battery holder.
Now this is the super glue.
Thank you. This is a super glue that I'm using. You can probably find this anywhere. What you do is you just put it, put a little bit behind your clock.
Over here. Be careful.
And put it on. Just give it a few seconds and it should be good to go. Alright, so now you have your base of the whole alarm system here. Now you need to find a place where you can put the motor. I usually put the motor here because there's no other place to fit it.
So we need again super glue, right?
So what you do is you take your super glue, let it get dry. Okay, now the motor is here, the base is here, the alarm is here. Just put your switch someplace where
you can put here.
I think it's better if you put it here. Okay. So put some glue. Okay, so the setup is almost done. You have your power source, motor, and the clock. The one end of the wire coming from the power source is left blank, that is, it's not connected. The other end is from the other end of the power source, goes into the motor. From the motor, it goes into the switch, and this is left. So the only thing for the motor to work is for this to be connected with this wire. Once the, you know, if you want to get up at 6 o'clock, this is how you do it. You first, the one wire that is closest to 6 o'clock is where you attach it to, right here, 6 o'clock, okay? Let me do this first, and then, you know, you can proceed. So, the wire is stuck. Now, as I told you, I would like to get up at 6 o'clock. So, this is where you have your wires pointing towards.
Thank you. Example.
Example, yes, example. Okay. Now what I do is I remove the minute hand.
Can I do it?
St- done, baby. Okay, you can remove the hour hand. Remove the hour hand.
Okay.
Good job. Okay. Then you take the hour hand and find yourself another wire. Usually you'll find this in the toy. Okay. Then sharpen both ends, you know, so that the wires are out.
Okay.
Then what you do is, this is the hour hand. Just paste it like this, you know, use the super glue and have it glued over here. Just make sure you don't get any on the hole. Yeah, thank you.
You're welcome.
So the wire is stuck. It's pointing, okay, like this. This is pretty much how it's going to be. Okay, so the wire is stuck at the eye hand. Now this point is pointing towards this wire, and this wire is up, pointing upwards. Now the other end of the power source, this is where you will be connecting the whole circuit to. What you need to do is you need to make a small loop, okay, and put this loop smallest loop. Thank you, Ayan. You have to make a small loop and smallest loop, and then put this inside the other wire. Okay, it's it. And what you do is, it's very simple. Why you do this is because the hour hand will keep moving, so you want this wire to be moving freely. So the last thing that you need to do is just use super glue. Super glue is very handy. And just paste
the fingers so
stuck to the clock and will not move. Now the whole connection is complete. The only thing you need to do is just make minor adjustments so that wires don't miss each other. It's always good to have this pointing up. Yes, there you go. Done. So basically what happens is, I have set the alarm at 6 o'clock. I will not need to switch the alarm on. It's just going to rotate by itself, and when the hour hand reaches 6 o'clock, when the hour hand reaches 6 o'clock, the connection is going to be complete. The current will start flowing, the motor will start moving, and the other end will come into play. I'll show you what to do with the other end. Now, the only purpose of us making this is for the motor to start working when it's 6 o'clock. Okay?
Let's test it, Daddy.
Alright, let's test it. The connection is complete, the battery is there, the whole thing is done. Let's go ahead and see if it works. You have to switch this on. And it touches 6 o'clock. There you go. It works. See, Ayan, it works.
Yay!
Again, 6 o'clock and the motor starts moving. And touch it. It's moving, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
It is not stopping.
It will stop when you switch this off.
Or
when it's not 6 o'clock. Okay? Alright, let's go to the next part of the video. Next, what you do is you take a scale, you take a small cup, you pour some water in it, but not now, later. Then you stick it towards the end of the ruler so that this is free to move. Okay? So how I decided to do that is like this. Taken a duct tape and rolled it so that it becomes like this. Okay, it's not sticky on either side. What you do is, you take this scale and you just make a small loop. You should have a little bit of space here, you see, a hole here. And you stick it across with another tape, okay? And the next step is to do the same with this. You apply the same technique that you did here, roll it up. Stick this on your cup. Just make sure when you do it on the other end, you put it inside the hole and then you stick it on the other end. Next, what you need is a small piece of wire. Again, you'll find this in a toy or anywhere. It's not necessary that you need a wire, you can use anything else. And what you do is, you cut a small piece of it. Bend it in, I'm sort of a hourglass, like this. Then you just stick it on your tail right here. Okay, this is going to be your trap right here. Okay, it has a small hole inside and your cup is free to move. All you need now is thread. Take a piece of thread, make a small loop around it. It's very simple to make. It goes under the trap right here. Okay, this way, and the next end needs to go to your cup. That's it. You cut the thread from where you think it's enough and you tie it around your cup. Okay, the experiment is nearly complete. Take another piece of wire and a fresh thread and tie the thread around the wire. Get your super glue. This is your alarm clock. All you need to do is just tie this to the other end of your motor. Okay, let me show you how to look towards the end. Next, what you do is you find a place at the proper height from your bed and find a place where you can stick your ruler or your scale on it so that, you know, when the water falls, it falls pretty much on your face. I found a very good spot right above my bed and I'm going to put it there. Okay, it's done. Okay, the final step of the whole experiment is for you to take the other end of the trap wire and tie it to the motor. Okay. Now you need to be very careful to measure how much of the thread you need to leave, so that you need to place this somewhere close to your bed. So I have measured and I need pretty much this size. I will take this and I will tie it around my motor. Okay, so the whole experiment is ready. I'll show you how it works. How you set this up is, first take the other end of the wire, the trigger, then place it in okay, now the setup is ready. All you need to do is just fill some water in here. Setup is set. All you need to do is wait for 6 o'clock.
Subscribe. Bye.
Bye.